have a look and try to find my face again. Buried beneath this house, my spirit screams and dies again. Outback, a monster wears a cloak of Persian leather. Behind the TV screen, I'm falling to my knees. I said, you got me where you want me. Makes me wanna sink my teeth in deep. Burn all the evidence of fabricated disbelief. Pull back the curtains, took a look into your eyes. My tongue has now become a platform for your lies. I said you got me where you want me. Flushed by all the fallen leaves, a hand holds up the sky while shamefully I make my plea. The altar's calling, but my legs won't seem to stand. Guess I'm a coward, scared to face the man I am.
Almost just hit a tree.
This is not gonna work.
You killed your family.
Focus. What's that gonna
do? Just make you stop laughing. No. Alright guys, so I hope you liked the video there. Took us quite a while to edit. That Dirt Jump track took us about probably a month and a half to build. It started out after April vacation. And then we pretty much went straight through till now. Well, until last weekend. It took a lot of effort to build it. It was pretty hard. The ground was different in all areas. We had like
roots and rocks and everything.
I think it was definitely all worth it in the end.
Time consuming, but worth it.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Yeah, like some of the holes we dug for the jump, for like one, the big jump at the beginning of the track, was probably about 6 feet deep. That got us in a little bit of trouble in the end. We didn't realize when we started, but we were actually building on, like, national wildlife ground. Some old guy walking his dog one day, the only guy we ever saw in there, walking down the trail, and he got pretty angry at us for doing this. So we're, like, ripping up the trail, we're ruining it, that a lot of people use the trail, which they don't, because we had been out there for probably a total of 24 hours by then, at least a full day's work, and we had only seen him. So not a lot of people had used the trail. We weren't really disturbing anyone, but probably him, who walks his dog there once a week. Now, fast forward to last weekend, we were out there, and we knew that he was pretty angry. Like, he would have called, the cops on us or something. Like, we had a good idea that people were after us now. Like, they know it's out there. And that they probably weren't too happy about it. So we're out there, me and Jake, we're out clearing off this cliff. We're going to do a nice cliff drop.
It was big. Nice cliff drop.
Probably like 5 feet, 5 foot drop. And we're just cleaning it out and everything. We weren't killing anything. We weren't chopping down any trees. Nothing illegal. And all of a sudden, I just turn around and I see Jake just staring at a tree. It's like staring. I'm like, Jake, you okay? And he goes, look at the tree. And we looked up at the tree and there was a trail cam that had been taking pictures of us.
All day.
Yeah, literally from 9 in the morning until like, what was it, like 4 at night?
Yeah.
It had to have taken, at least like 1,000 photos.
We didn't even know if it was photos or video.
Photo
audio.
Or video.
If it was with video with audio, we're pretty screwed, but yeah.
Yeah, because like they had us talking and they would have heard our names and everything. Yeah, they have pictures or video of us, so we're probably not going to be able to ride on the track anymore, which is kind of disappointing.
Probably end up after filling it in.
Yeah, once we get caught.
We didn't really know that it was big.
Since a lot of time went into it, and a few good wipeouts later, Jake.
Oh, yeah, I got a bunch of bruises and cuts on my legs.
Yeah,
working on the rainy days.
Messed up his rotator cuff, couldn't play baseball for about 2 weeks.
Oh, yeah, that kind of sucked. Still hurts today.
It was actually filmed with 3 GoPros right here. This is a GoPro here, and then 2 Hero 2s. Then my Canon T2i Rebel with a 250 optical zoom lens. Yeah, and we used manual focus. That's how we got all of our shots. We didn't use autofocus or anything. That's pretty much all I'll be using for my videos coming soon. Since now that we can't add any more to that track, since we're in trouble now, one of our friends, Isaac, I'll actually add his channel in the description below. He asked his uncle, he offered that, if we could, his uncle has a ton of land behind his house, and he asked if we could go build, a 3-minute long, just downhill bombing track. Jump line, bridges. It'll be pretty cool. We can do, whatever
quite
we
want. Quite a bit of land, 24 acres of land.
Yeah, no limits there, just whatever we want. Which would be pretty nice. We don't have to worry about getting in trouble or anything.
Sometime this summer.
Yeah, probably by the end of the summer that video will come out. Probably going to be, a half hour long, just documentary-type, movie-type thing. Easily the biggest project ever.
That's kind of what we wanted to do out of this, but, I'm getting in trouble here, so.
Yeah, we'll have to, make our own trail and everything. That should be pretty cool. Yeah, so definitely stay tuned for that. Subscribe to both of our channels. Yeah, so I hope you guys like that video. Thanks for watching.